This is the biggest fencing tournament in the world, and this is the biggest one we've had. We're currently running 77 strips, which is bigger by at least 6 or 7 strips than last year. The sport is growing, which is good. These events are getting very large.
I fence for Northwest Fencing Center. It's in Beaverton, Oregon. At my club, I've seen a lot of growth just in the time I've been there, from not only like doubling the size of the club, but the number of fencers that go. And I've also seen like a lot of interest for it as far as people coming to places just to watch. We definitely need to get more people fencing, because the more people I have, just the better the sport gets overall. So
I'm an armorer. We have all this equipment because all of the fencing is scored electrically. And all the equipment needs to be tested to make sure that it works and that it's safe. And armorers check all of the personal equipment to make sure that it meets all the rules. And we're also responsible for the scoring equipment that's out on all the strips. So whenever anything breaks, the referee calls the armorers, we come out and fix it. So there's 3 weapons, and each weapon has different equipment. So the saberists have more, and the FAS have less. And the foils are in between.
I think it really helped, like, mental skills and just planning. For me, it also is kind of a time management help. You take time for training and other practice, and it's not like you can sit down and do your homework while you're there. You actually have to participate, and it helps you just learn how to organize your schedule around things. And then our coach, he likes to have us, during camps, build our own schedule. So he's like, you have to go home and hydrate at night. You have to rest. And he's like, I want you to pretend like you're at nationals during camp. And I think it really helps a lot.